Now let's shift focus here to Assam. We're looking at Priyanka Gandhi, who's hectically campaigning in Assam, caught up with India Today, while Rajdeep Sardesai spoke in an exclusive conversation with her. He did speak to her about the party's prospects, while Priyanka Gandhi pointed fingers straight at the BJP, saying the BJP is trying to polarize the state, and also spoke about the Congress party's relevance in the gamut of things. Let's cut across.
Mrs. Gandhi Vadra, this is your second visit to Assam in 2 weeks. Do you really think the Congress has a fighting chance in this state?
Absolutely. The Congress is fighting a very strong and united battle, not just against the BJP's government here, but against their ideology, against the fact that there is an assault on Assam's identity. And it has taken place in the last 5 years with great effect. And the people of Assam recognize this, they see it, and the fight that we are fighting, really, it's not the Congress party's fight, it is the fight of the people of Assam.
The reason I'm asking you this, in the last few years, the Congress has struggled in Assam. So what has suddenly changed for you to get this confidence?
Well, look, people 5 years ago wanted to give the BJP a chance, they gave it. They believed in the promises that the BJP made, as I enumerated these promises while I was speaking. But which of these promises have they kept? So at the end of the day, people are not foolish. People are wise. Yes, when they think that somebody is coming with a new hope, they have faith in that. They want to try it. Now they've tried it. They've seen that none of these leaders were here. When there were floods, none of them came. Nobody came and cried over Assam. Nobody even came to hear the voice of Assam when CAA was implemented. Nobody came to ask, why are you agitating?
But
so when nobody has come in 5 years to even ask, to recognize that this is the pain of the people of Assam, that they are fighting for their identity and for their culture, then do you think the people of Assam will not recognize this?
Because you've made 5 guarantees: non-implementation of CAA, tea workers will get higher wages, you've spoken about women getting 2,000 rupees, you've spoken about free electrification. Now, many will say, how can you non-implement CAA? It's a central legislation. Is the Congress playing politics over the Citizenship Amendment Act?
See, look, this accusation of playing politics always somehow comes only on the Congress party. We are all political parties. The greatest politics that is being played here is by the BJP. And the politics is that when elections come, we will give you all sorts of promises, we will lie to you, we will come here, we will shed tears, but the rest of the time we really don't care a hang what happens. That is the greatest politics that's being played.
They say the Congress plays politics of Hindu-Muslim. How do you respond to them when they say Congress is making...
Are you serious?
No.
In Assam.
No, it's a question in Assam which is being asked, that the BJP says the Congress has tied up with the IDF.
The BJP's entire effort in any election is to polarize. And especially when they have no ground to stand on. When they have done no work here in the last 5 years, they have not proved themselves in terms of development. They have not proved themselves in terms of economy. They have not proved themselves in terms of jobs. What's the only thing left? The only thing left is to rely on polarization to win the election. That is what they're doing again and again and again. And as I said before, people are not foolish. People eventually are seeing through what is happening.
Can I ask you that, is this a make or break election for the Congress? Because May 2nd, 5 states that if y'all don't win, the Congress could break. There could be a... How important is this election? Just in Assam, but these 5 elections.
Look, this is something that is said about the Congress party in every election. Make or break, the Congress will disintegrate. The Congress is there. The Congress is not going anywhere.
The Gandhi family.
The Congress is not going anywhere. The Congress is not the Gandhi family. The Congress is an idea. The Congress is an idea on which India was built. The Gandhi family is irrelevant. It can be this family, this leader, that leader. It is the idea that is alive. And the idea will remain alive, and the Congress party will embody that idea as long as it exists.
All right, we're looking at fresh face-off between AAP and the Lieutenant Governor right after the contentious NCT bill was passed in the Lok Sabha. We're looking at the Lok Sabha passing this contentious Government of National Capital Territory of Delhi Amendment Bill, giving more powers now to the Lieutenant Governor. According to provisions of the NCT bill, the Delhi government must obtain the LG's opinion before implementing any decision here. In fact, the Lieutenant Governor can also specify the matters on which opinions have to be sought by him. In fact, Delhi Assembly cannot conduct inquiries on administrative decisions anymore. The legislative proposals to be sent to the LG at least 14 days in advance. Now the Lieutenant Governor can refer a bill to the President as well. Soon after the bill was passed, Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal tweeted calling it an absolute insult to Delhi. The Chief Minister also accused BJP of cheating the people of the national capital.
प्रजातंत्र का हत्या हुआ ये गलत है. उनका कुछ लिमिटेड पावर्स है, उस आधार पर ही सरकार चलना पड़ेगा. क्योंकि जो अधिकार, जो कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इस असेंबली में यही संसद किया है, इस संसद का जो आदेश है, निर्णय है, जो एक्ट है, जो भी स्टेट है, उसका पालन करना पड़ेगा, उसका पालन करना पड़ेगा. हम बात कर सकते हैं, भाषण दे सकते हैं, उसके आधार पर ये संसद का एक्ट नहीं बदल सकते. इसमें कोई राजनीतिक दृष्टिकोण से कुछ भी नहीं है, सिर्फ टेक्निकल ग्राउंड्स पे हम आज इस अमेंडमेंट से लाए. बहुत सालों से इस विषय पर सुप्रीम कोर्ट में, हाई कोर्ट में चर्चा हो रहे, इसलिए सुनवाई चाहिए. इसलिए मैं आप लोगों से अनुरोध करना चाहता हूं, यूनानिमसली इस अमेंडमेंट्स को पास करने के लिए मैं अनुरोध करता हूं.
धन्यवाद. मिसमैनेजमेंट ऑफ दिल्ली, जो कि एनसीटी ऑफ दिल्ली के नाम पर कांग्रेस ने ही किया था, और आज उसको ठीक करने की बारी आई है तो बीजेपी की जो केंद्र सरकार है वो उसको कर रही है. इतना ही शौक था तो उस वक्त दिल्ली को पूर्ण दर्जा दे देते राज्य का, क्यों नहीं दिया? वो इसलिए नहीं दिया क्योंकि जितने नियम हैं, जितनी रिपोर्ट्स हैं, उसके खिलाफ थी. तो केवल एक राजनीतिक जीत के रहते ये काम किया गया, लेकिन उसका जो बुरा असर है वो आज हम सबके सामने है.
लोकतांत्रिक तरीके द्वारा चुनी गई सरकार को शक्तिहीन करना, ये कौन सी अमेंडमेंट है? अब ये पिछले 22-23 साल से बीजेपी दिल्ली की सत्ता से बाहर है. पिछली बार इनकी 3 सीटें थी, इस बार इनके 8 हैं. तो इनको ये हार न पचा नहीं पा रहे हैं. राज्यसभा में विरोध करेंगे, बहुत सी पार्टियों ने यहाँ पे विरोध किया है, क्योंकि किसी की बारी आ सकती है कल.
It's now former Mumbai Police Commissioner versus the Maharashtra government. The top cop, Parambir Singh, has hit out at the Maharashtra government, now reaching the doors of the Supreme Court, seeking a CBI probe against allegations that he's made on Home Minister Anil Deshmukh over alleged malpractice. In fact, Parambir demands for a CBI probe into his transfer as the Police Commissioner of Mumbai as well. He's also demanded that there must be a probe into CCTV footage of Deshmukh's home. In fact, Parambir has also broken his silence on the allegations against him, accusing Anil Deshmukh, the Home Minister. Parambir hits back at even Sharad Pawar, saying that Sachin Waze has met with Anil Deshmukh multiple times in the past. He's even gone on to clarify. Parambir Singh says there's no political intentions. He has no intentions of being deployed by the centre. He's not met any BJP leader. He only says that he's trying to uplift and honour his reputation and self-respect. And therefore, he writes this letter. In fact, Parambir's clarification here comes right after NCP Supremo Sharad Pawar attacked him twice in 2 days, saying that he is blatantly lying. Pawar also claimed political vendetta behind Parambir's letter. Now, we're looking at a huge political churn right after Parambir's explosive letter, where he accuses Anil Deshmukh of demanding Sachin Waze to extort 100 crore rupees every month.
So while he was waiting up to second week of March for the whole month, this is an important issue. It was his duty, at least he should say something in writing. At least it was his duty to register such and such things to certain records, but that is not done. He has disclosed this, all these things, when he was about to transfer and he transfers.
All right, we're looking at a coronavirus surge in Maharashtra, which is quite worrisome. We're looking at a daily spike. The latest numbers has come today itself, recorded 30,535 new cases in just the last 24 hours. We're looking at the mark, crossing the 30,000 mark for the first time since the outbreak of the pandemic. The daily case count, Maharashtra recorded 99 deaths as well in the last 24 hours, taking the death toll now to 53,399. Mumbai has also recorded its highest ever cases, registering 3,775 cases and 10 deaths on Sunday alone. Meanwhile, Pune, Nashik, Aurangabad, Nagpur also reported highest single-day cases ever. Maharashtra has seen 1,81,889 fresh cases in just the last 8 days. So far, 43 lakh people have been vaccinated in the state so far. The central government, along with monitoring bodies, have now come up with new, fresh, revised guidelines to administer the COVID-19 vaccine, Covishield. Under the revised guidelines here, the second dose of the Covishield vaccine will now have to be administered between 6 to 8 weeks apart instead of the earlier interval of 4 to 6 weeks. So far, about 28 days gap between first and second dose was being observed. Now the center notifies that at least 6 to 8 weeks of gap, 2 weeks more that's added to this interval here. In fact, in the letter to the states and union territories, the government has said the decision was taken since a longer interval between the jabs only improves immunization. In fact, the guidelines were updated following emerging scientific evidence and on the recommendations of two expert vaccine panels there. The vaccine cannot be administered beyond the 8-week period. The change is applicable only for Covishield and not Covaxin. In fact, earlier the World Health Organization recommended extending the interval between two doses to enhance immune response. The 67th National Film Awards has been announced, and it seems like a huge tribute to Sushant Singh Rajput as his film Chichore has won the Best Hindi Film of the Year. The late actor Sushant Singh Rajput's Chichore here has got some great honours. Along with that, Best Actress Award has been awarded to Kangana Ranaut for her movies Manikarnika and Panga, while the Best Actor Award has gone to Manoj Bajpayee for the film Bhonsle. Bajpayee shared the Best Actor Award with Tamil actor Dhanush for his film Asuran. In fact, the awards were initially going to be held in May last year, but were delayed indefinitely due to the coronavirus pandemic.
Everybody, thank you very much कि आप लोगों ने इस फिल्म को सफल बनाया और ये पुरस्कार आप लोग मेरे साथ शेयर कीजिए प्लीज. और पंगा मैं सिर्फ एक कलाकार एक्टर की भूमिका से रही हूँ. और अश्मी मैम थैंक यू वेरी मच, नितेश सर, निखिल जिन्होंने कहानी लिखी, बलू सर, विजय सर फ्रॉम फॉक्स, शिखा, दिस फिल्म इज ऑफ सो मेनी पीपल.
All right, for more information on that, you could log on to indiatoday.in. You could also download our app for more. Stay tuned, coming up next.
Hi everyone, Preeti Chaudhary here. Hope you like this video. For latest news and analysis, like and subscribe to the India Today YouTube channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated. Thank you for watching.